In a previous video, we have seen the authentication and authorization of several REST APIs using the Keycloak, and the application was built on the Quarkus. Authentication and authorization was done using the annotation. As you can see here, this authenticated was used for authentication, roles allowed for authorization, and if you want to allow APIs to be public, we were using permit all. In this video, we'll see the same kind of configurations, but in the application.properties. So here you can see I have added the configurations. I'll just explain them and then we'll see the demo of the same thing. We had the annotation called authenticated, which was used to authenticate the APIs. Similar kind of stuff what we have in the properties is quarkus.http auth.permission. Whatever the name you want to give over here. Right now I have given here it as authenticated dot paths equals slash star, which means all the REST APIs in this application should be authenticated. And this configuration tells us the path information for authenticated APIs, and this configuration says what policy we need to use. Here the policy is used as authenticated. Quarkus by default provides three policies predefined. Those are authenticated, permit, and deny. So these policies are already available and you directly use them without defining any specific policy before using them. So we can use these three policies. So the next configuration here we have is for permit, which means it allows these REST APIs to be accessed without even authentication. From the previous configurations, I have added slash public in my REST API path, and the policy which I'm using for these paths is permit, which is by default defined by the Quarkus itself. And because I do not have any REST APIs for deny, so I did not add any of those. Now coming to the roles allowed. You'll see in the first two definitions, we did not create any policy. But here we need to create a policy for roles allowed because we need to provide specific roles to them. What we need to do is here Quarkus HTTP auth policy dot whatever the policy name you want to give dot roles allowed equals admin. In a sense, I am creating a policy with name admin role policy, and this policy will have the roles as admin. The next definition is similar to how we have done in the previous configuration. So this is my restaurant path, and for this restaurant path I need to give the policy as admin role policy. So you can see this in here, this is the slash restaurant, and I'm defining the policy for this create restaurant, which was admin. The same thing. Similarly, the roles allowed configuration for the other REST APIs, like creating a menu, checking the list of orders for a specific restaurant and details of the order. For these REST APIs, we had the role as manager. So I have created a policy with name manager role policy, and this role policy will be assigned to these APIs. All right. Let's now start the application and try to execute some of these APIs to see if our configurations are working as expected. And you have already seen here, I have commented all the annotations which were used for authentication and authorization, and my Keycloak is also up and running. Let's start the application now. Application is started. Let's check in here. So to get the list of restaurants, we do not need any authorization header and no body and nothing else. Just send and you'll see the list of restaurants. And the menu for the restaurant 1027, which was this Krutanga, you'll see these are still working and these do not need any authentication, which was defined in here, this one. Now let's try to create a new restaurant, and to create a new restaurant we need the admin role. Let's see, create a restaurant. I'm creating this new restaurant and authorization is still not there. So our admin was admin itself, but I'll try to generate a token for Amar. Let's see what happens. Amar is the owner, and using this token, so it says forbidden. So Amar doesn't have the access to create the restaurant. So it was admin send. We'll use this. Now the restaurant has been created. If you see in the list of restaurants, you'll find Nirvana. So this means all of the configuration, what we have done over here, are working as expected. So we had two problems. The one was like removing our hard coding configurations of authentication and authorization from Java file. That we have done. But the second thing is still there in the application itself, which means I'm still configuring the authentication and authorization information within the Quarkus application itself. We can get rid of this by moving all these configurations in the Quarkus. We'll see in the coming videos. So that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.